Baruch Hashem Yahweh Adonai. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Today, my dear brothers and sisters, we are going to read a beautiful word from Job chapter 1 verse 21. It says, "Naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked shall I return there. The Lord gave and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord." Yes, this is a word where it shows great pain, and also it is having a confidence in the Lord Jesus Christ, where Job is speaking. The response to suffering is our today's day's word. Yes, in the hour of suffering, the Christian should attempt to determine, first of all, just why he may be suffering. One can suffer because of his position or his disposition. Peter brings this truth out in his first epistle. "Servants, be submissive to your master with all fear, not only to the good and gentle, but also to the harsh. For this is the commandable, if because of conscience towards God, one endures grief, suffering wrongfully." 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 18 and 19. Suffering is often a two-sided coin. One of the side suffering may be viewed as coming from God to bring out the best in us. See Genesis as we read in chapter 22 verse 1 and 2 and 15 to 18. Hebrews 11 verse 17. On the other side, Satan attempts to use the same temptation and suffering to bring out the worst in us, as we read in James 1 chapter verse 13 and 14. Finally, the believer can react to suffering in three different ways. First, despise it, that is, to treat it too lightly, as did Esau, his birthright, as we read in Hebrews 12 verse 5 and 16. Second, faint under it, that is, treat it too seriously, that is in Hebrews 12 chapter verse 5. Third, be exercised by it, that it is, receive instruction from it. This is the reaction desired by God. Yes, pay attention over here. This is the reaction desired by God, as we read in Hebrews 12 verse 11 and 13. During this time, both Peter and Paul advise us to commit our pain and suffering to God, realizing that, as we read in Hebrews chapter 12, verses 11 to 13. During this time, both Peter and Paul advise us to commit our pain and suffering to God. Yes, commit all your pain to God, your suffering to God, realizing He is faithful to work out all things for our good and God's glory, as read in Romans 8:28. Yes, everything is happening in our life. It is for the glory of God, as read in Peter 4 verse 19. James tells us to count it all joy when we experience these dark hours, as read in James chapter 1 verse 2. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, it is very difficult, as we see, to undergo pain and suffering, because we all are human beings, isn't it? So when pain and suffering is coming because of some kind of sickness, because of any kind of torture, because of any kind of the grief, sorrow of somebody dying in our family, or any kind of sorrows, yes, what do we have to do? My dear brothers and sisters, at such a time, we have to cast all our cares upon the Lord, for He cares for us. As we read in the mighty word, 1 Peter 5:7, Peter and Paul are telling us, yes, we have to give all our burdens, all our cares, all our problems, all our sorrows, all our griefs in the Lord's hand. For the word of God says, as we read the mighty word, it is speaking to us. Yes, As we read the mighty word, it says, "He whoever desires to follow me, yes, let him deny himself, let him take up the cross and follow me." Yes, we have our everyday problems and grief because some of our loving person, our loving family member has passed away. And there is a lot of sorrow. But the word is saying to us in Jeremiah chapter 31, verse 16-17, it says, "Refrain from weeping." Yes, because our loved ones are safe in the Lord's hand. And we are going to see them once again, we will see them. Yes, as the word says, and as we read in John, yes, chapter 11, verse 25, it says, "Jesus is the resurrection and the life. And he who believes, yes, even though he dies, he shall live." Yes, this is a very important word. Even though he dies, he shall live. So why do we sorrow? Rejoice, my dear brothers, sisters. Commit all your pain and sorrow in Lord Jesus' hand. Yes, because we are going to meet our loved ones very soon as Jesus, our loving Father, is going to be there and we're going to be with him and see our loved ones once again. So cheer up, my brother, my sister. Commit all your suffering in the Lord's hand. Let us pray. Yes, Abba, Father, yes, we come in your mighty presence. As we commit ourselves into your hand, we pray, wash us with thy most precious blood. Forgive us of all our sins that we have done knowingly, unknowingly. Take care of each of my brothers and sisters. Yes, all those who are in pain, sorrow, grief, agony, and in sickness, we pray. And also those who are in the grief of their departed ones, touch them. Yes, let the shalom Yahweh shalom alechem, shalom Yeshua shalom alechem be there with each one of us. Yes, and bless us and take care of us and lead us, guide us and help us. As the word says in Psalm 32 verse 8, yes, we pray in all these things we are more than conquerors as we read the mighty word from Romans chapter 8. Yes, be with us, take care of us and bless us. For my God will provide all your needs in the glorious richness of Yeshua Messiah. As we read in Philippians 4, yes, by verse 19. Thank you for this time to pray. This prayer we ask in name of Yeshua Messiah. By the Holy Spirit we pray. Amen and Amen.